Bam! Mr. Taru, in this math lesson, we're going to take a look at an example of finding the angle between two planes. And I've got now quite a large list of math lessons dealing with the mathematics of vectors. I'll put a link to that playlist in the description if you'd like to check out some more of my other lessons. But we have this diagram here where we have an orange plane and a purple and a blue plane intersecting at some kind of angle. How are we going to find that? Well, the angle theta between a plane with normal vector m and a plane with a normal vector n is equal to the angle between the lines in the direction of those two vectors. So there's going to be a similarity here between finding the angle between two lines and the angle between the intersection of two planes. One similarity is we do have these planes that extend in all directions, not like a vector that has an initial point and just goes in one direction. So when we found the angle when we found the angle between two vectors, we were accepting answers between 0 and 180 degrees. Well, with these planes and lines extending in multiple directions, you know, lines too, and planes in all kinds of directions, we're only going to be concerned with that acute angle between the intersection, not necessarily the obtuse angle, which of course you just subtract from 180. But that's why they're talking about lines going in the direction of the vectors and not just measuring the angle between the vectors themselves. We're going to limit those answers between not 0 and 180 degrees, but between 0 and 90 degrees. Okay, so we have theta is equal to the arc cosine of the absolute value of the dot product between vector m and vector n, the dot product, scalar product, inner product, whatever your textbook is calling it, divided by the magnitude of vector m times the magnitude of vector n. Now, when we found the angle between two vectors, it was the same formula basically, except there was no absolute value function here. We had that absolute value function there when we were finding the intersection or finding the angle between two lines. Why is it there? Well, in terms of planes, how are you going to find these normal vectors? If your plane's given to you in a Cartesian format, you can just pull that normal vector right out of the equation of that plane if it's in Cartesian format. If you have the equation of your plane given to you as that original vector format, which is vector r, describing position vector for any point along in the plane, equal to vector a, position vector for any known point on the plane, plus u times maybe alpha, plus vector v times the scalar of beta, and we had that addition of the scalar multiples of two non-collinear vectors, well, you would find that normal vector by doing the cross product between the two non-collinear vectors, which are the directional or the sort of gradient vectors for that particular plane. Well, we know that the cross product is not commutative, right? The cross product of v and u is, well, if I have that the cross product of vector u and vector v is vector m, then if I change the order, I'm going to get an opposite vector. That's mainly why the absolute value functions are in that equation given us, that's going to give us the equation for theta. And look in here, if we were looking for that acute angle between those two vectors, or in this case between those two planes, if we take an opposite vector, we're just simply going to get the obtuse angle. Like, think about your unit circle from way back, right? The cosine of 30 degrees is square root of 3 over 2. The cosine of the supplement of this angle, the obtuse part of it, would be 150 degrees. Now, when we were studying unit circle, we would just highlight how this is in quadrant 1 and this is in quadrant 2 with that same 30 degree reference angle. You would get not the same answer, but opposite answers. So the absolute value function is in here to make sure that the angle that we get is going to be that acute angle that we're looking for between the intersection of those two planes. If you happen to set up your cross multiplication and get your normal vectors so that you would have gotten that obtuse angle, well, that's all that we have here. Acute, obtuse, the only difference in the answer is the signs. The absolute value function will take care of that. Let's take a look at our first example right now. For our example, we're going to find the angle between the planes defined by a couple of equations in different formats. We have one here that is in Cartesian format, and we have one here that's in our sort of original standard vector form for the equation of a plane. So we can see how to handle these differently. In this part here, our plane x minus 3y plus 2z equals 1 is given to us in Cartesian format, and if we're looking for a normal vector, that's awesome, because vector r dotted with vector n equals vector a dotted with vector n. This equation for a plane using a normal vector just comes right out and gives us an equation in Cartesian format. So this one is the resultant of a dot product, inner product, scalar product of vector a and vector n, two vectors with, you know, all of our components we know, they're all constants, giving us a numerical value. Over here, just to really point this out, we have vector r, a position vector for every general point on our plane, x, y, and z being dotted with our normal vector, our coefficients 1, negative 3, and 2. Here, right there, is our normal vector 1, negative 3, 2 for one of our planes. Now, drawing our attention over here, this format is great if I want a couple of non-collinear parallel vectors to this plane, but it is going to cause, it's going to require us to do a little bit of extra work for finding that normal vector cross product. So if this is vector u and vector v, the cross product of vector u with vector v is equal to, now let's pull off to the side and give ourselves a little bit of guide for scratch work. 3x3 matrix, you've been seeing me do this now probably, I hope, if you're watching more than just one video, quite a bit. We're going to set up this 3x3 matrix and set up a, go through the determinant process by setting up some small 2x2 matrix. We're going to take out that row and column with our I component, and we're going to take the determinant of matrix 2, 0, negative 1, 2, going across the rows. And that's going to give us a scalar multiple for the I component. Now we have a positive determinant minus the next determinant. We're going to take out the row and column with component j, negative 3, 0, 2, 2, giving us a scalar multiple for our j component. And then finally we're going to add our last determinant. So again, that positive minus positive determinant, taking out our row and column where the k component is to create a coefficient for our k component vector, negative 3, 2, 2, negative 1, times vector k. That's going to say that, give us that the cross product is equal to these components. We have 2 times 2 is 4, minus 0. Multiply down positive, multiply up diagonally, that's going to give us a subtraction value, minus negative 3 times 2 is negative 6, and that's 0 for our j component. And then finally, plus negative 3 times negative 1, which is 3, minus 2 times 2, which is 4 for our k vector. And our cross product is going to yield us that normal vector, which has the components of 4, 6, negative 1. I'm pausing because I see that there's an error somewhere. That error is the fact that I have a negative in my notes, and right here I wrote a positive. But you know what? Let's just roll with it. I'll grab a calculator and finish up my angle when we're done here. So we have this as our normal vector m to this equation, vector equation of a plane, which is not what I intended to do, but I don't want to reshoot the scene over just because I forgot to copy a minus sign or a negative. Our angle, grab some maybe orange chalk here, theta is going to be equal to the arc cosine of the absolute value of the dot product between vector n, which is 1, negative 3, and 2, dotted with this normal vector here of 4, 6, and negative 1, absolute value of that again, except it's not going to leave me enough room for my magnitudes. The magnitude of vector n is going to come from doing 1 squared plus negative 3 squared plus 2 squared times the square root of, or find the magnitude of vector m, 4 squared plus 6 squared plus negative 1 squared, and squeeze that in right there. Beautiful. So we have the theta is equal to the arc cosine 4 plus negative 18 plus negative 2 over the square root. We've got 9, 10, 14 times the square root of 36 and 16, which is 36, 46, 52, 53. Again, with the absolute value, we're looking at theta is equal to the arc cosine of negative 20, negative 16 over the square root of 14 times the square root of 53. Absolute value, which is going to get rid of that negative. And that comes out to be, with the aid of my little calculator here, 54.029 degrees. Hope that helps you understand how to find the angle between the intersection of two planes. Hey, by the way, when you're doing your work, make sure you copy those answers or the problem right to begin with so you get the right answer, even though you hate to get all these points marked off just because you have a copy error, like you might lose a point on the IB exam. Anyway, I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go to your homework.